Did you know manufacturers produce over 80 billion pieces of clothing globally each year?
Or that 80% of that clothing is landfilled or incinerated?
How about the delivery trucks bringing new clothes to your house, accounting for over 18 million tons of carbon dioxide emissions worldwide?
I'm your host, Naia Butler-Craig, and you're watching Learn This, a mini-series that investigates the big topics affecting your world right now and what you can do about them.
You probably know the phrase, reduce, reuse, and recycle. But most people don't realize that reuse is the best and easiest way to contribute to the health of the planet. But how we reuse things is where it helps to get a little creative.
My name is Maya Penn, and I'm a 21-year-old environmental activist, sustainable designer, a sustainability consultant, and an artist and animator. All of my items are made from either recycled, vintage, or organic materials, and I'm always experimenting with new things, biomimetic design, biofabrication. The average piece of fast fashion is designed to last about 10 wears before it essentially just starts falling apart. A lot of people feel like they have to buy their way into sustainability. That is not true. For example, shopping your friend's closet, learning how to mend your clothing, simple sewing, spot washing your clothing. If you have to, you know, wash it in the washing machine, then do it on cold water when you can. Also using traditional methods like using natural fruit, vegetable, or herbal teas to dye fabric, using natural earth pigments to paint on fabric. If you're shopping, you know, just completely new, of course, see if that brand is sustainable, if they have any sustainability practices in place, and really pay close attention to the fabric of the clothing that you're buying. Is this an organic material or is this a synthetic material?
Some of your favorite brands are already starting the groundwork to improve their practices, like announcing plans to use 100% sustainably sourced materials. 150 brands have already joined a pact to reduce the clothing industry's environmental impact. Those are steps in the right direction, but they'll take time. So what can we do?
Here's the takeaway. Next time you go shopping, take a look at the label.
If it's natural, organic, or recycled, you're in the right place. Recycled cotton uses fewer resources than virgin cotton. Natural fibers, like hemp and linen, grow with very little water. And organic fabrics are made without pesticides that can be toxic to other living things. The clothing industry runs on what you put in your closet, and by changing how and what you buy, you can directly affect its future environmental impact.
The biggest issue with getting even more young people interested in the environment is they feel disempowered. People feel like they are one drop in the ocean, but every drop creates a ripple effect. When you think about the fact that you are reusing, recycling, mending your clothing, those little actions are being done by millions of people. It's growing more and more every day. I really do believe in the power of collectivism and the power of collective positive actions, and also the power of collective voices holding the big industry leaders and world leaders accountable as well.
In other words, instead of focusing on a few people doing sustainability perfectly, it's time to focus on a lot of people doing sustainability imperfectly. And you can wear your efforts on your sleeves. I'm Naia Butler-Craig for Learn This. See you next time.